हेलो, वी आर गोइंग टू सी न्यूटन्स लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन फ्रॉम केपलर्स लॉ. सो सी हाउ दिस न्यूटन्स लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन इज डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम केपलर्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ प्लैनेटरी मोशन. लेट अर्थ इज रिवॉल्व अराउंड द सन इन एलिप्टिकल पाथ विथ एवरेज डिस्टेंस स्मॉल आर एंड लेट small m denotes the mass of earth. So in that condition, when a body revolves in circular path, required centripetal force F is given by formula mv square by r. In place of V, we can write R omega. By putting this value, one may write the centripetal force is MR omega square. Right? Now, when this earth revolves around the sun, required time period for revolution, we are knowing time required for one period. It is represented by T. It is time period is equal to this circular path 2 pi by its angular velocity 2 pi by omega. This implies that omega is equal to 2 pi by T. Putting this concept in above equation, we may write centripetal force as F is equal to M R. Here in place of omega square, we may write 2 pi by T whole square. So by keeping this value, we may write F is equal to 4 pi square R by T square. The required centripetal force can be written by this formula and represented by equation number 1. Now using third law of Kepler's, that is square of time period is equal to kr cube. See here. Here in the formula there is m also. M is carried here. So we are, and it is represented by equation number 2 here. Now what we are going to do? We are going to put the value of T in equation number 1. One may write F is equal to 4 pi square R m by K R cube. Now see carefully, this expression can be written as 4 pi square by K m by R square. See here in this equation. Here 4 pi square by k is a constant. This is constant, so it can be written as the force, centripetal force required to revolve the planet around the sun is directly proportional to the mass represented by equation number 3 here. And this required centripetal force is also inversely proportional to 1 by r square. So by this mathematical calculation, we may obtain three important results. The centripetal force which is required to revolve around the sun is towards the sun. So first fact is, required centripetal force is along to sun always. The one thing. See carefully, this is now second mathematical required centripetal force is directly proportional to mass of moving planet. In this case, third, required centripetal force is, see here, 1 by r square. It is called inversely proportional to, what is inversely proportional to? Distance between sun and earth. So this is called Newton's laws of gravitation, and this Newton's law of gravitation is derived by third law of Kepler's, that is T square is equal to kr cube. Here in this whole concept, the constant which is obtained here, 4 pi square by k yp, this is constant, one thing, constant 4 pi square by k is a constant, and it is a scalar quantity. So this is all about Newton's law of gravitation from Kepler's law. Thank you.